Good afternoon, basketball fans. Welcome to our 3 o'clock matchup between the Cypress Wildcats and the Westlake Chaparrales. First, let's meet the Cypress Wildcats. They're coached by Chris Drought, assisted by Lance Vogel and Jason Williams. At guard, 5'9" junior, number 4, Bryce Richardson. At guard, a 5'9" sophomore, number 5, Trey Weston. At guard, a 5'9" senior, number 11, Jordan Houston. At guard, a 6'2" senior, number 31, Jared Lilly. And at forward, a 6'4" senior, number 41, Hogan Choice. That's your start lineup for the Cypresswood Wildcats. And now, the Chaparrales of Westlake. They're coached by Robert Lucero, assisted by Bo Wilkes, John Blanco, Sean Mallard, Chase Hargis. At guard, a 6'2" senior, number 4, Jacob Fleshman. At guard, a 6-foot senior, number 5, Matthew Jernigan. At forward, a 6-foot junior, number 10, Alex Nehosen. At post, a 6-4 senior, number 33, Stephen Odunsi. And at point guard, a 6-foot sophomore, number 45, Luke Fleming.
Well, there you have it, Mr. Yannick, on the starting lineup for each of these two teams. Cy Woods and Westlake going at it today. Just in case, let's go over that one more time. Cy Woods will start off with Bryce Richardson, Trey and Wesley, Jordan Houston, Jared Lilly, and Hogan Choice. And Westlake will start off with Jacob Fleshman, Matthew Jernigan, and Alex Nahasen, Stephen Odunisi, and Luke Plyman as well. Both of these two teams, have won their first games. Westlake defeated Reagan very handily in the first game here in the main gym. Cy Woods defeated Brennan, and they pulled away from that game in a very high fashion there in the fourth quarter, as Jordan Houston just went off in the second half, 32 points. He led the way. He was the main shooter for them. Here in the other end, the first shot of the game, no good. That from Odunisi. Trey and Wesley amazingly hit 16 free throws in that game, as he just found a way to get to the line so often. Cy Woods was in danger of losing that game for a moment, and they pulled away there at the end, as I mentioned earlier. Here with a foul and a shot attempt. Sharon again will head to the line. Too hard off the iron. He'll have one more. Foul went against Bryce Richardson, his first. So he gets one of two. There's the first points of the game. Here's a three-point attempt, the first one. And no good by Wesley. Always trying to get the rebound, but cannot. It'll go to the Chaparrales. Wyman trying to drive, almost losing the ball. He's guarded by Wesley. We'll get the high pick and a little pick and roll. And now a shot in the outside off the back of the iron. Too hard. Offensive rebound, though. Kicking it back out. Three-point attempt this time is up and good by Plyman. 4-0. Like taking control so far. Cy Woods will get it over to Houston. Here comes the high pick set by Lilly. Houston will go around it, and he'll look for choice down low. Cannot find him. Ball comes loose. Lyman ends away with it, or ends up with it. Another three-point attempt. Off the iron, no good attempt by Fleshman. Houston down the other end will lose it, and last touched by Westlake. The Wildcats retain possession. Three-point attempt off the back of the iron, no good. Rebound went to Odunusi. But Westlake moving around right now. Looking down inside, deflected and stolen. Here on the other end is Houston. He draws no contact and will end up throwing it away. Well, he draws contact, but no whistle, rather. So a turnover by Cy Woods gives Westlake the ball right back. Plyman over to Jernigan. Cutting it inside, and a nice pass inside. The dunk nearly missed, but manages to get it to up. Go is Steven Odunisi. His first points of the game. Nice movement by Westlake. So Cy Woods down the other end. Wesley with the ball, looking to go inside. Now pass it outside to Hogan Choice. His shot gets it to rim in. First 2 points of the game for Cy Woods. Choice getting it to go. Down the other end, Plyman will try his luck with a three. Gets it to go. Second three-pointer of the night for him. Or the game for him, rather. He's got 6 points, 9-2. Quick lead for Westlake, and that one bounced off by Lilly as he gets it off of one of the Westlake players, but I think they're going to say, nope, they're going to remain with Cy Woods' ball. So Wesley, who only had one field goal last game, but all those free throws will inbound the ball to Houston. He'll fire a three, and he hits. It's the man they want to get on fire if they want to get going. He had 32 last game. First 3 points for Houston. Here's a three-point attempt by Westlake. They respond right back. Cunningham comes right into the game and makes his presence felt. Three-pointer for him. And he also probably gets a reach and foul, trying to take it away from Choice. So the first personal on Cunningham. Inbound, Wesley to Houston. Gets it back over Wesley as he crosses the court to receive it. Spins, dribbles, gets it on over to Lilly. Lilly looking for him right back, and he does in the corner. Goes down the baseline, tough shot, but he draws the contact. He'll head to the free throw line. Mayde free throws last game for him. Only one field goal he made. That was the first one when he got an and one. He hits his first free throw here. Thompson will check in for Choice. Palmo on the other end for Westlake will check in as well. That free throw by Wesley hit again. So he goes 2 for 2, and now with a 12-7 lead. With Westlake leading, excuse me. High off the backboard, no good. Offensive board, no good as well. They still get it, another attempt, and they can't get it there as well. Coming away with it this time is Cy Woods. Three attempts by the Chaparrals, and they can't get it to go. Houston wanted to foul there. He was not going to get it as he'll go down as missed field goal for him. A three-point attempt. No, he's going to look down low. And that is missed. Offensive board, though, picked up. Still no good. And as Willis was trying to get it to go, and Cunningham right behind him with the board trying to get it to go as well. They'll end up going to Cy Woods. Here's a three-point attempt. It is up and good by Lilly. 12-10. Pass inside, deflected by Lilly, and he almost came away with it. Now here's a tough three-point attempt off the rim. No good. Rebound to Cy Woods. Here they come down the other way. It's Houston. He's running down the lane, left-handed lay-in. Couldn't get a good gripping on it, and he will not be able to convert. Down the other way is Westlake. Right-handed lay-in is up and good by Plyman. He's got eight. Houston looking down low to Thompson. Kick it back out. A fake by Lilly. A bounce pass now inside to Thompson. He can't handle the pass and he loses it. Coming away with it is Westlake. Cross midcourt. 2 minutes remaining in the quarter. A fake and now floater is up and good. A nice one there by Matthew Mayer. His first 2 points. Pass to the outside. England, didn't see much of him in the first game. Another three-point attempt by Houston is good. Six for him in the quarter. So 16-13, Cy Woods has cut this lead to three. Bounce pass to Willis, he'll just hand it right on over to Mayer. Gets it right back and up and good is Willis. First bucket of the game for him. Just over a minute remaining in the quarter. England looking to pass it, does. Finds Lilly, now he gets it over to Wesley. Wesley to England, he's looking to shoot. He doesn't get a good open look like he would have liked. Now he's just looking to pass it, does to Houston. Houston drives down the lane, a lot of traffic, loses the ball, but contact down below and a whistle. We'll give him two free throws. Nine seconds left on the clock. Free throw attempts for Houston. That one too strong off the iron. We'll have one more. Houston getting to the free throw line quite often last game as well. 8 of his 32 points coming via the free throw line last game. He gets one of two here. 7 points for him in this game. Bringing the ball up is Fleshman. He'll hand it off. And they still move it around, and that one is up and in. The big man's going to get that one to go. Matthew Mayer, all 6-7 of him. He has four. And a 20-14 lead for Wesley. Cy Woods swinging it around. Go around to pick. Houston to fire, and he hits. Houston, 10 points. Cutting it back down to three. With 20 seconds remaining, they may hold to the last shot. Mayer with the ball will go around to pick. Now he'll drive, and a lot of traffic down below as three defenders for Cy Woods came in to try to stop him, but he draws contact from one of them. And we'll get two shots out of it, two free throws. Ten seconds left. First free throw attempt is no good. Second one is good. So one of two from the free throw line is Mayer. He's got 5 points. Houston driving down the lane, and he hits it off the glass and good. 12 points for him now. Last second heave, almost gets it to go. Was Fleshman, but that will bring us to the end of the first quarter. A tight one after it looked like the Chaparrals were taken off. It is 21-19 lead for Westlake. We'll be right back here on TexanLive.com.
AllSpas is so much more than Ace Hardware. Sure, we have nuts and bolts, lawn and garden, faucets and fixtures, lights and locks, even outdoor cooking. But AllSpas is also a boutique featuring the finest names in jewelry and home accessories. But most importantly, AllSpas is a friendly, helpful family of people who take pride in their products and services. AllSpas is Ace Hardware, and so much more.
Welcome back into the Insperity Holiday Classic here at Kingwood High School in Kingwood, Texas. TexanLive.com. I'm Mark M. Johnson along with Reed Harmon and Will Betts here in the main gym. Dre Matula is in the other gym broadcasting that game. Or airing that game, rather. 21-19, Westlake with the lead on Cy Woods. 12 points for Jordan Houston after a 32-point performance in that first game and that win against Brennan early this morning. Jared Lilly with three, Hogan Choice with two, and Wesley with two as well. Down on the other end, Luke Plyman with 8 points leading the way for them. Stephen Odunusi and Cameron Willis with 2 points each. Brock Cunningham with 3 points so far after the first quarter. Houston getting it on over to Wesley. Now Houston driving again and a little swoop underneath, trying to get it to go in, cannot. Rebound goes to Westlake, driving in is Plyman, and he gets it rejected. It looks like Choice got a piece of that, but they're gonna get a 3-point attempt out of this one and they get it to go. Fleshman with his first 3 points of the game, increases the lead 24-19. Choice on over to Burns, he goes behind his back, nicely done. Otherwise, it would have been stolen. Ends back up in the hands of Houston. He goes around a high pick, puts it up. The shot would not have counted anyway. A high pick coming from Thompson. Looks like the foul goes against Plyman, his first personal. In the corner, Burns with a three-pointer. It is up and good. His first 3 points for Burns tonight. During this game. Whistle. And it's going to be a foul. Pushing foul. Jordan Houston picking up his first personal. Third team foul. First free throw attempt. No good from Matthew Mayer. As he did last time, gets one of two. So 2 of 4 from the free throw line for him so far. He's got 6 points. Leslie guarded by him, will go around him. Help coming from the side. We'll stop Wesley from going to the rim. He gets over to Burns. Now back over to Wesley from the top of the key. He'll drive the lane. He'll look for the shot. Draws the contact. Head to the free throw line. Matthew Mayer with the foul. His first personal. Free throw is good. Third one for him. 3 of 3 from the line. Free throw is good as well. He had a lot of practice in the first game. On the free throw line, gets his first 4 to go here, and the lead is cut to 25-24. On the left now, passing it to his big man inside, and he's gonna be rejected immediately. It looked like Lilly got a piece of him. Now Austin with the attempt. Now Burns with the three-pointer, and he gets another one to go. And for the first time in this game, Cy Woods has the lead, 27-25. 6 points for Burns. Going down low, they're going to lose. A choice ends up with it, and he'll hit it on over to Wesley. He goes up, and he's fouled. Well, they're going to call a charge. So he cannot draw the contact in his favor this time. Will go against him. Still a 2-point lead for Cy Woods, though. Pass over the left side. Now we get the ball back in. Fleshman. Cunningham thinks otherwise about the three. Will drive it anyway, and the fadeaway, oh, rims it in. Cannot get it to go. Lilly with the rebound for Cy Woods. Hit over to Wesley. Cross midcourt now. Not much movement down low, as he'll pass it off in the corner. Looks like Burns with the ball. He almost gets it picked off. Goes right in the hands, conveniently, of Houston. Houston will turn, give it over to Lilly. Lilly dribbles, and he will just hand it over to Westlake, and an easy lay-in down on the other end after the steal was Plyman. He's got 10. 4:44 remaining in this half. All tied up, 27-27. Lilly with a pick. In the corner to Burns. He's looking down low to Lilly. And Lilly trying to find something, and he does. Choice is what he finds. Nice lay in there from Choice. And back on top by two, 29-27 is Cy Woods. Swinging it around, there's a shot from the corner. Too hard, no good. Offensive rebound, though, ends up in the hands of Odunisi. He's got 4. Odunisi, excuse me. Burns. To the right side now. Wesley will hand it off to Lilly. And last touch. Looks like by Westlake, so Cy Woods will retain possession. Cy Springs, a winner over North Shore. In the other gym, off the back of the iron, no good. Rebound to Westlake. Up ahead, and reading that one well was Lilly. And he comes away with a steal, but Cy Woods will just throw it right back over to them. Possession-wise, it looked like Richardson was looking for Wesley, and he couldn't handle the pass, so they'll give it right back to the Chaparrals. That lane is good. Up. 31-29 as Westlake takes their lead right back. Driving down the hole and missing it. Too hard off the glass was Wesley. He's trying to get the steal on Cunningham. Cannot come away with it. Under three minutes remaining now. Plyman in the corner. 3-point attempt is good. Matthew Mayer, 9 points now for him, and they got their 5-point lead back, 34-29. Thompson out to Wesley. England off the glass and good. Nice touch there from Thompson, his first two of the game. Back to a 3-point game, 34-31, 2:20 remaining in the first half. There's a whistle. It's going to go against Cy Woods. Cy Woods, the returning champion of the Insperity Holiday Classic. They beat a very, very tough Atascocita Eagle team last season. After that game went neck and neck, was pretty much going back and forth before Cy Woods ended up the winners behind Samir Sahik, the MVP of the tournament. Here's a three-point attempt from Westlake. Good. Joe Palmo this time with the triple, his first three of the game. 37-31. Lead for Westlake. Houston over to Lilly, but there is a whistle down the floor. And they're going to say that there was a push. Odunsi with the foul. His first personal, 17 foul, so that will head. Well, that will give Thompson a 1-1. He cannot convert, almost ends up with it, but it bounces around in the hands of Plyman. He gets over to Cunningham now in the corner. Cunningham with a cut and a nice pass coming in from Mayer. And Cunningham has two more. He's got seven. Lead now 39-31 with 120 remaining. Cy Woods' lead was very short-lived. Here's a three-point attempt that's up and good for Bryce Richardson, his first field goal of the game. Just over a minute remaining in the second quarter. Cunningham with the ball. Palmo. Over to Plyman. He'll drive, he'll stop, fire, hits. Nothing but net for Plyman. 12 for him. Increases the lead 41-34. 35 seconds. Houston passes it off. Driving, now gets it back to Houston. He'll stop, fire, and cannot get the roll. Great rebound from Mayer. Gets over to Plyman, and he's coming down the lane. He'll fire back out, and it's going to be stolen by Wesley. 16 seconds left. He's going to drive. He's going to fire. He's going to hit. And an opportunity for an and-one is Wesley, his first field goal of this game, though four free throws has him at 6 points. Lilly will come out. Choice into the game. Burns also checking into the game for Richardson. The and one is complete. So 7 points here in this first half for Wesley. 6 seconds remaining. Here's a pass, Plyman with the ball. He's gonna pass it out in the corner. Here's the final shot of the half. It is up and good. Joe Palmo with a second three-pointer of the game gives them a 44-37 lead at the half. Second half begins after this intermission here on TexanLive.com.
At Panera, we decided a long time ago to avoid the easy road and switch to antibiotic-free chicken. That decision set a lot of things in motion. So now it's not just chickens raised this way. It's more ingredients you can trust. Which has taught us a lesson. Sometimes what you think is the harder road turns out to be the only one worth being on. Panera Bread. Live consciously. Eat deliciously.
Welcome back into the second half here on TexanLive.com. We're at the Insperity Holiday Classic. First round is over. We are now into the second round. And Westlake taking care of business against Reagan. Cy Woods taking care of business against Brennan. And that is why each of these two teams is here right now. First half. Saw a lot of scoring. Leading the way for Cy Woods was Jordan Houston with 12 points as the ball goes out of bounds over to Cy Woods. Wesley had 7 points, 5 of those come in the free throw line. Bryce Richardson had 3, and Jared Lilly had 3 as well. Hogan Choice had 4, and Thompson had 2 for Cy Woods. Houston with the ball, trying to find Choice down low. On the other side, Westlake was led by Plyman, who had 12. Matthew Mayer is pretty close behind him. He had 9. Palmo had 6. Odunsi had 4. As the three-pointer comes up, and no good from Lilly. He gets his own rebound, though. It's back up top to Houston. Fleshman had 3. Willis had 2. Those were your first half stats. And a foul is going to go. Let's see who they call this one on. There it is. Second personal foul against Plyman. So once again, headed to the free throw line. And cannot get the second one to go. But they get the offensive board. And here, with a three-point attempt, rims it out, no good. Offensive board, though, by Lilly. He can't get it to go. Choice looks like he may have come away with it. But it may be a jump ball. It is. Cunningham coming in along with Mayer. Cunningham had 7 points in the first half. Here's a three-point attempt after the inbounds. Good by Lilly, but the whistle before the shot will go against Cy Woods. And the foul goes against Hogan Choice, his first personal. Cunningham. Fleshman now ends up in the hands of Cunningham. He'll fire a 3 off the back iron, no good. Choice with the rebound. Gets over to Richardson. Now he'll fire it over to Wesley. He drives. We'll just hand it off to Lilly, and he gets it to go. 5 points now for Jared Lilly. And the assist for Wesley, 44-40. Swinging it around, ends up in the hands of Cunningham. He'll do a pump fake, fire, a layup off the glass, and it is good. Cunningham now with 9 points off the bench. Richardson gets it over to Wesley. And he swings all the way around the court. Now Houston on the right side will take it down the baseline, and a lay-in almost finds its way in, but cannot. Rebound goes to the Chaparrals. Lyman gets it stripped from behind by Wesley. They give it right back over to him. He takes it up and will just hand it over to an easy layup for Richardson. Nice play there from Wesley. Bring them even closer, 46-42, another assist for the Wildcat point guard. Yeah, they're looking for him to shoot, so they're finding those open lanes. They try to scoop it inside, and it's knocked away and stolen in the hands of Richardson. He'll take it to the right side, fire cannot hit. Choice gets a hand on it, And it looks like it'll last be touched by the Wildcat Chaparrales to take over. Inbound. And we're ready to go. Under 5 minutes remaining in the third. Here with the ball, goes inside, finds Cunningham. He'll work down the baseline, scoop it up and in. That was pretty. 11 on the night, or on the game for Brock Cunningham. Richardson finds Thompson. He'll swing it around the arc over to Wesley. He'll drive, picks it up, and what a drive from him. Cannot get it to go, though, but there to pick it up is Thompson. He can't get it to go. Cunningham with the rebound. Mayer with the drive and lays it up and no good, but contact. He will get the foul. He was looking for it. Very athletic for a 6'7" guy. His first free throw finds its way in there. Ten points now for Matthew Mayer. Rims that one out, cannot get it to go. So one of two from the line for him. Here comes Wesley the other way. In the corner, wide open, uncontested three-pointer. You don't want to do that with this guy. Jordan Houston makes him pay. So 15 for him. Cunningham at the top of the key. Swing it around. Now find Mayer down low. He'll keep swinging it around. It looked like he had an open look, decided to pass it. Off the rim, no good. Cunningham coming in there to get it, and he's fouled. Trying to put it back up and in. He'll head to the free throw line. Jernigan looked like he had an open shot after the pass, but it could be very intimidating down low with Choice and Thompson right there. So he gets a second one to go. Wesley over to Houston. He'll fire another three, trying to get hot, and he rims this one out. Rebound. Goes to the Chaparrales. Cunningham stops for a moment, takes it in, and gets the foul and the bucket. Well, they're going to say the foul happened before he shot it. So do not count that one. Inbound goes to Cunningham. They're not going to need it because Cunningham with a lay-in. Fifteen for Cunningham off the bench. Losing the ball is Burns in the corner. Mayer knocking it away from him. So Cy Woods keeping the ball. Plyman will come out. Fleshman will go in. Houston, another three-point attempt. Cannot find it there. He was really heating up last game. Cannot find his groove. He's hitting shots, but not as consistently as he did last game. Cunningham with the spin, fires, and cannot convert. Actually, an offensive foul is going to be called against Cunningham, it looks like. Third personal foul on Cunningham. Wesley gonna take it up. Cross midcourt now. He goes to the right, finds a little lane, spins, and I cannot believe he even got that shot off, but he's well short. He can hang in the air for a long time. Down the other end and putting it up, and there was a foul call before he could get the shot off. So Mayer drawing contact and getting the foul once again. Three-point attempt, up and good. Increases the lead, 56-45. Almo with 9 points, all of them three-pointers for Westlake. Driving is Houston, he puts it up and good, finds his groove there. 17 for him. Mayer going around the pick. He's double teamed, he'll throw it down inside. Now looking outside. And the jumper off the iron, no good by Niehausen. And a loose ball foul is gonna go against. Yep, Niehausen is gonna get the foul. Second personal for him. Now five team fouls. 1:45 left here in the third. Westlake kind of taking over in this quarter. Don't count the Cywood Wildcats out just yet. As I say that, they lose the ball. Palmo. Inside, what a pass from Mayer over to Niehausen. Niehausen, and he gets his first 2 points of the game. Up and good. And I believe that is an and one. So coming right back the other way is Wesley. Gets a second field goal of the game. Only third field goal of this tournament. Has gotten to the free throw line quite often. Already 6 free throws for him in this game, and he's attempting number 7. And he's got it. So that'll put him at 11 for the game. He cuts the lead 58-50. I'm sure they're going to want to dwindle this lead down as much as they can before the end of the quarter. Lessen the damage. Westlake has other thoughts, though, I'm sure. Lyman gets in the corner. They swing it around. Here's a three-point attempt. It is rejected by Burns. Bryce Richardson, or excuse me, Jacob Fleshman with the three-point attempt. Burns got way up there to get that rejection. Both teams in the bonus. Fleshman gets it in the corner again. He'll try it on the other side. He cannot come away with it. Yaman gets it up and good, but a whistle before the shot. And Houston will go to the free throw line. Seconds remaining. First free throw attempt is good. Makes it a 59-50 game. One more on the way. Houston hits them both. 4 points for him. As Odunsi will check in for him. 10-point lead. Wesley, kind of taking his time, not much movement down low. He may be playing to last shot. As he makes a couple of passes with Lilly, Mayde's trying to run some more time down. He goes to the right side. He's heavily guarded there. Puts it up and in, Wesley. With yet another and one attempt. Trying to go for point number 14 on the game. He's got it. 7-point game, 3 seconds left. They're gonna get time for one last shot. Here's the heave, and no good. From Joe Palmo, who already has 3 three-pointers in the game. We've played 3 here at Kingwood High School. The Insperity Holiday Classic, second round between in the winner's bracket. It is a 60-53 lead for Westlake on top of Cy Woods. We'll be right back here on TexanLive.com.
The body is incredibly powerful. It's nimble and fluid. But sometimes we push it too far. That's when you need the strength of Memorial Hermann and our body of affiliated orthopedic specialists. With our Ironman Sports Medicine Institute, they not only get your body back to where it was, they get it to go further. It's what makes us more than just hospitals. We are a body of experts. Memorial Hermann, advancing health.
Well, it's 3 quarters in the books, 1 quarter remaining, 60-53. Is a lead for Westlake on top of Cy Woods. And a nice and one there at the end from Wesley to make this a single digit lead. But for the most part, Cy Woods has been in trouble. They haven't gotten Jordan Houston to heat up like he did last game, although Jordan Houston still has 18 points. Or 17 points, excuse me. Looks like they're going to call a foul against Wesley. And already in the bonus the rest of the way are both teams, so it's going to be one and ones until either team reaches a double bonus. Wyman hits his first free throw of the game. He's got 13, looking for 14. He's got it. 62-53. Chaparrals with the lead. Wildcats still trying to stay in this game. Houston driving down the lane will lay it up and get it to go. Perhaps this is where he turns it on. He's got 19. A running cut inside. Now in the corner, trying to get a shot off, but Houston all in his way. Jernigan gets it back out, and now foul going against Westlake. It'll be their 8th team foul and the 3rd personal foul on Luke Plyman. Houston almost losing the ball out of bounds, and they're going to say it was last touched by Jernigan. So Cy Woods retaining possession. Wesley gets it in to Houston. Back over to Wesley. And Houston will fire a 3, and that is good. 22 points. Ball is loose. Burns ends up with it. Cy Woods only trailing by 4. Firing it is Wesley, and he cannot convert. The only one underneath the basket was Lilly. And it ends up in the hands of Westlake. Lyman driving the lane. He's got lots of room. He fakes one, and he gets through. He cannot get it to fall. Offensive board, though, goes to Chaparrals, and taking it right away is Cy Woods. Houston driving. Left-handed hook, no good. 2 minutes gone by. A very fast-paced, exciting fourth quarter. as Westlake still with the lead by four. Kleiman going around the pick. Will use the floater, can't get it to fall. Offensive board ends up in the hands of Musin. And Kleiman back out top with it. He'll get it over to Musin. He'll spin with the hook. Cannot convert. Offensive board trying to keep it alive, and they're going to say that it was out of bounds. Last touch by Cy Woods. So Westlake's going to head to the free throw line. Mehusen. 2 for 2 from the free throw line. And one, and the first one is good. So with his other field goal, he now has 5 points, looking for 6. And trying to increase this lead to 6. He does so. .533 remaining in the game. 64-58. Lead for Westlake on top of Cy Woods. Houston with the ball, will go to the right side. He'll fire a three, and he's got it. 24 for Houston. Cuts the deficit 64-61. Westlake in the double bonus. The rest of the way, not far off though, is Cy Woods. Tip up is up and good by Cunningham. And a timeout is gonna be called by Cy Woods to talk this one over. 66-61, the lead for Westlake on Cy Woods with 4:51 remaining in this game. We'll be right back here on TexanLive.com.
Register online at CESPerformance.com for your sports performance program. CESPerformance.com has multi-month memberships and team training. CESPerformance.com has baseline performance testing included with every athletic development program. Schedule your athletic evaluation at CESPerformance.com. There's no cost or commitment. Be prolific at CESPerformance.com.
It is a 66-61 game. Cy Woods trailing Westlake. And as I said last game, although it was much earlier in that game against Brennan, they are in danger of not repeating as champions. Westlake, a very good team, trying to take care of business here and eliminate Cy Woods from winning this tournament, at least in the winner's bracket. Only 4:51 remaining. Wesley to inbound. He does so to Lilly, and Lilly gives it right back to him. Houston. Probably be heavily guarded. Plyman's all over him. High pick set, but he's going to go around it, and he's going to drive it, and he's not going to convert. Rebound goes to the Chaparrals, and here down the other end, getting 2 more points to his name is Matthew Mayer. 68-61. Easy lay-in the other way for Cy Woods. .68-63. 4 minutes remaining in the game. Kleiman driving. Too hard. Off the iron, no good. But keeping it alive was Jernigan, and over to Plyman as Cunningham controls right now. He'll go around with choice all over him to the right side. Now the top of the key will stop, and a little floater from about the free throw line. Mayer trying to get it to go but cannot. Loose ball. And it's going to be a loose ball foul against Westlake. So Jared Lilly, head of the free throw line. He had 6 points in the opening game, all of them free throws. Cannot hit the 1-1. That was a big miss from him. Kleiman gets it over. Hujerin again. Now Cunningham with the ball, dribbles down the baseline. Looking inside, Jaren again gets it up and good. His first field goal of the game. In trouble now, they get the pass off to the corner. Down the baseline, off the glass, nicely done by Wesley. Fleshman with the ball will go down low to his 6'7" big man who fires it back out. And a little floater, nothing but nets from Plyman. Points for Plyman. Down the other end, Wesley gets it to go, and he's going to get another and one attempt. Boy, he is so good at getting to that line. And when he converts his and ones, it's just icing on the cake for him. Well, they're actually going to say he didn't get the shot off, so that's why he's shooting two free throws. I was a little confused there for a moment. Gets this one to go, though. Points now for Wesley. Down the baseline, Plyman to the top of the key. Now to the outside of Cunningham. Looking down low. Turning, firing. The whistle was blown before that shot went in. By Mayer. But in the double bonus, he will head to the free throw line. Gonna call the foul against Burns, his first personal. Mayer with one more on the way. He's got 14 points, looking for 15. Got it. Increasing the lead to 74-67. Cy Woods will opt to call a timeout, trailing Westlake. You're listening to the Insperity Holiday Classic here on TexanLive.com.
Cerna is a local family-owned business located right on Will Clayton, and a one-stop shop for your home, auto, liability, and business insurance needs. Please stop in or give us a call at 281-812-9775. We're also proud to support all of the Humble ISD athletes.
There's only 2 minutes remaining in this game. The Chaparrals have taken a 74-67 lead on the defending Insperity Holiday Classic champion, Cy Woods Wildcats. So Cy Woods with one last attempt here to try to get into this game, try to make it a little bit more closer, trailing by seven. They're going to need a bucket here, that's for sure. Here's the inbound from Lilly to Wesley. Wesley to the right side, he'll pass it off. Houston. Dribbling down, will pass it inside, not able to handle the pass as his teammate, and out of bounds. That was a tough turnover for Cy Woods as the Westlake Chaparrals will take over. Cunningham gets it up ahead. Hyman gets it over to Mayer. Lyman's going to be fouled, a reaching foul by Burns. It's going to be his second personal. So in the double bonus, you'll head to the free throw line. 1:33 remaining, both teams in the double bonus the rest of the way. Lyman hits his first one. He's got 17. He's looking for 18. He's got it. 18 points for Luke Plyman. And a 10-point lead for the Chaparrals. That's the right side. It's rejected by Cunningham. But picking it back up and putting it in is Cy Woods. .110 remaining. There's going to be actually a timeout taken down on the floor. So with 1:10 remaining, 76-69 is the score. We'll be right back here on TexanLive.com.
AllSpas is so much more than Ace Hardware. Sure, we have nuts and bolts, lawn and garden, faucets and fixtures, lights and locks, even outdoor cooking. But AllSpas is also a boutique, featuring the finest names in jewelry and home accessories. But most importantly, AllSpas is a friendly, helpful family of people who take pride in their products and services. AllSpas is Ace Hardware, and so much more.
Well, Cy Woods is running out of time. They trail 76-69. Just over a minute remaining in the game. After the fantastic run that they had last year's tournament, they're always the ones people are going to gun for as the defending champion. The second place team, Atascocita Eagles from last season, are not in this tournament. So up for grabs if Cy Woods cannot take care of business here. 1:10 remaining exactly on that clock. Inbounding the ball. Chaparrals getting a foul. Burns picking up his third personal. Lyman headed to the free throw line. Pretty good free throw shooter, as we've seen here tonight. Hitting his last two. He's got four made free throws so far in this game. Make that five. Luke Plyman's got 19. He's looking for 20. He's got it. Three-point attempt from Houston is off the mark. No good. And that's, I think, been the key for them. He hasn't really gotten going. He's got 24 points, I believe, but hasn't really taken off with the amount of shots that he has taken and the foul. Over on the left side by Choice. 44 seconds remaining. And Jacob Fleshman headed to the line for the first time tonight. First one, cannot get it to go. He does have 3 points on his three-pointer earlier in the game. Second one, he gets this one to go. 79-69, three-point game. Here comes Wesley. He's going to take one off the glass. No good. Cunningham coming away with it. And a foul. Immediately with 35 seconds remaining, that should just about do it. Fleshman with 4 points after that. Cunningham headed to the free throw line once again. He's got two made free throws so far in the game. His first one on the way, cannot get it to go. That free throw will give him 18 points on the game. Off the bench, not a bad performance. Houston firing a long three, no good, rebounded and taken away. Now ends up in the hands of Richardson. Momentarily looked like Matthew Mayer had come away with it and somebody stripped it from behind him. And Richardson gets it, gets fouled, head to the free throw line. Only hit that 1 3-pointer, Richardson. Now he's got this free throw, so 4 points on the night, looking for five here. He's got it. Final 23 seconds. And they're gonna foul once again. This time it's Matthew Mayer. Headed to the free throw line with 20 seconds remaining and a 9-point lead for Westlake. Rims this one out, no good. Still got one on the way. It's that one. Final 16 seconds. Wesley gets it to go, and he is fouled. Well, I don't know what the record is for the amount of and-one attempts in a game, but I'd imagine he's quite up there in this one. Wesley now with 22 points, going for 23, cannot get it. Tipped out of bounds, last touch, it looked like by Brian England. Pass in with 11 seconds remaining, it is off the fingertips. Houston ends up with a 3-pointer, no good, shorts, and that'll do it. 81-73, the final score. Westlake defeats the defending champion, Cypress Woods Wildcats, and they will move on to the next round of this winner's brackets. We still got much more basketball here at the Insperity Holiday Classic. Up next is Cy Falls and Lamar. That's coming up at 4:30. We'll have the live coverage of that game as well. So we'll see you in a little bit here on TexanLive.com.